Hello friends, welcome back. In this lecture we are going to see features of peptide. In previous lectures what we have seen, the classification and some important topic regarding the amino acid like amphoteric nature, zwitter ion formation, and we have discussed about the titration curve of the amino acid, which is an important topic from the amino acid. Now further continuing with the same topic, amino acid, we will discuss the formation of peptide bond. These peptide bonds are important because these peptide bonds are the backbone of the polypeptide chain or protein. Therefore study of these peptide bonds is important, and hence we are going to study or we are going to see what are the features and how peptide bonds are formed and what are its importance in polypeptide chain. So let's consider features of peptide bond and peptide bond formation. Amino acid. Amino acids are joined together to give the formation of a polypeptide bond or give the formation of a polypeptide chain by amide linkage. That linkage is called as a peptide bond. These peptide bonds are present in the proteins, and proteins are the larger molecule. Hence the study of this peptide bond is important. Now let's consider what is peptide bond. Here we can see that a amide bond between the amino acids are called as a peptide bond or peptide linkage. The amide bond means there is a presence of a nitrogen attaches with a carbonyl. That bond is called as a amide bond. How this bond is formed? This bond is formed when first amino acid carboxylic group and second amino acid amino group. That means two amino acids are there which combine together or which gives the formation of an amide bond. This group combine to form a peptide bond by removing of a water. So here we are considering that the first amino acid carboxylic group and a second amino acid amino group. These are involved in the peptide. So two amino acids are linked together by the peptide bond. Now let's consider the two amino acid linked by peptide bond and forms a dipeptide. So we are saying that when there are two amino acids are attaches with each other by a peptide bond, then it is called as a dipeptide. Similarly, if three amino acids are there, then it is called as a tripeptide. If four are there, then it is called as a tetra, and it is continued further. Now when we are considering these amino acids peptide bond, we are simply saying that if there are n number of amino acid present in the peptide bond, then there will be n minus 1 number of peptide bonds. So in a polypeptide chain, if there are 10 amino acids, then we are saying that it is having a 9 peptide bonds. Okay, on the basis of these peptide bonds, what we are considering, a classification of an polypeptide as a oligopeptide and polypeptide. Okay, now if peptide is made up from less than 10 amino acids, residue, it is called as a oligopeptide, and if it is made more than 10 amino acids, then it is called as a polypeptide. So we can have again two definitions, oligopeptide and polypeptide. What are oligopeptides? Oligopeptides are the peptides in which there is a presence of less than 10 amino acid. There is a presence of less than 10 amino acid in a peptide linkage. While if that is more than the 10, then it is called as a polypeptide. So this is the classification we have seen. Now let's go further for a formation of a polypeptide bond. Okay, now in this slide we are having peptide bond formation. Peptide bonds is nothing or is formed by condensation of an two amino acid with removal of an water molecule. So it is simply a condensation reaction between the two amino acid and which gives a formation of an amide linkage, and they are joined together. Now you can see here. Here we have shown a one amino acid. This is the first amino acid. This one is the second amino acid. These two are different, R1 and R2. Now, amino group of an one amino acid and carboxylic group of an another amino acid, they are combined together to give the formation of an amide linkage. So the lone pair of this nitrogen will attack on this. This will transfer here and this will go as a OH. Okay, so there is a removal of an water molecule. So we can say that the carboxylic group of this first amino acid, amino group of the second amino acid, there is a joining of these two. With the removal of an water molecule, so minus H2O, and this gives the formation of an amide linkage or a peptide bond. This is the amide bond. Now we can see here, this name given as a peptide bond. So first amino acid and second amino acid, they are joined together by the peptide. So it is a dipeptide. Now further consider in the feature, here we are saying N-terminal free amino group. What is the N-terminal free amino group? Now you can see here, two amino acids are joined. This amino group is free. Therefore, it is called as a N-terminal. Okay. So here with the different color, amino group. Okay. That is free for further addition of another carboxyl group here. So therefore, N-terminal. Here nitrogen is available. So we are calling it as a N-terminal. Now next is a C-terminal. C-terminal means here is a carboxylic group which is available. So it is called as a C-terminal. We are saying it as a C-terminal or carboxylic group terminal. Carboxylic group is free. That means it can have a further addition of an amino group from this side. So we are getting the addition of an amino group. When we are considering the addition of an next amino group, it will give the formation of an tripeptide. This is the image we have taken from this reference. Okay. So this is the slide which explains how the peptide bond is formed. Now what we'll do, we'll revise this quickly. Why we are revising this quickly? The reason is quite simple, because this is the one of the very important topic from the amino acid. Okay. So what is peptide bond? Peptide bond is a condensation of an two amino acids, okay, by removal of an water molecule. Here carboxylic group from the one amino acid and amino group from the another amino acid, they together combine with removal of an water molecule and gives the formation of a peptide linkage. This peptide linkage is nothing but a amide bond. Okay, this peptide linkage. Now we are having two terminologies, N-terminal free amino group and C-terminal free carboxylic group. Okay, what is N-terminal? N-terminal means in a peptide linkage where a side where a amino group is free. That is called as a N-terminal. Here you can see it is called as a N-terminal. Here carboxylic group is free. Carboxylic group is not involved in the amide linkage. That side is called as a C-terminal. N-terminal and C-terminal, these are the two important features. For general sign convention, it is considered that N-terminal should be written on LHS. That means it is considered that it should be written on the left hand side, while C-terminal should be written on right hand side. Okay, it is for the our check of convenience. Okay, or it is scientifically considered that like on the left hand side in the polypeptide chain there should be N-terminal and at the right hand side there should be the C-terminal. Now let's consider next, that is the features of the peptide. The scientists Linus Pauling and Robert Corey was doing the X-ray study of the protein molecule, and in that they have studied the polypeptide chains and polypeptide chain study. During that study, they have determined certain features of the peptide bond. So let's consider what are the features of the peptide bond and how they are going to help in understanding the structure. The lone pair on the nitrogen atom of amide bond delocalize over the oxygen of carbonyl group. So in a amide bond, whatever the lone pair is present in the nitrogen, that can delocalize on the from the nitrogen to the oxygen with the help of an resonance. Now this gives bond planar, that amide bond as a planar nature. Why? Because carbon nitrogen bond has a considerable double bond character. What is the reason for this double bond character? The reason is that lone pair on the nitrogen atom can be shifted over oxygen with the help of a resonance. Therefore, it is having a planar nature as a carbon double bond nitrogen. So this gives a planar nature of the peptide bond as well as it is having a considerable double bond character. Due to this, you can see here how that delocalization happens. From the nitrogen lone pair, it is shifted here, and we are having shift of this on the carbonyl. This results into formation of this structure. Here we can show a resonance. You can see here a lone pair with this arrow, it is move here, and further it is delocalized on the oxygen atom. So what we are getting charge on the oxygen, and here we are having the plus charge on the nitrogen. What it gives the formation of here a sp2 hybridized carbon. This sp2 hybridized carbon is a planar, therefore a peptide bond is having a planar nature, and this planar nature is due to the delocalization of the carbonyl. Now let's consider the another feature. Rotation around the carbon nitrogen bond, which is shown here with an violet color. This peptide bond carbon nitrogen bond is not rotated. Rotation around this is restricted. Why rotation around this is restricted? Because nitrogen lone pair is involved here for resonance, which we have seen in the previous slide, and O minus. So here considerable double bond character and double bond carbon rotations are not possible. While C alpha nitrogen, that is a C alpha and this nitrogen, C alpha nitrogen. The second we are considering, that is a C alpha C means this. C alpha nitrogen, that is this, and C alpha C means R group, or C alpha C here we can say a carbonyl, similarly here also carbonyl. So this group can be move, or they can be rotated, because there is a presence of single bond character, or there is a single bond between this alpha carbon R group, alpha carbon nitrogen, alpha carbon carbonyl. Similarly for this alpha carbon carbon, alpha carbon R group, and alpha carbon nitrogen, these all bonds are single, while only there is a double bond character between amides. So this can rotate. This rotation, what it gives? It simply gives that the more stable arrangement or more stable orientation of an atoms in three-dimensional space. So here one of the more important feature, this gives stable three-dimensional structure with opposite orientation of the R group to minimize the steric hindrance. Here you can see R groups are on the opposite side. So these are the R groups which are on the opposite side to each other. Hence there is a minimum steric interaction, and minimum steric interaction, it gives more stable molecule. Okay, so the polypeptide bond is stabilized by this. So due to double bond character, these rotations are restricted, so molecule become planar. And due to the presence of other single bond rotation, that is alpha carbon and all other single bond rotation, it simply gives a more stable molecule and having orientation of the R group on the opposite side. What it implies, it gives two structure, that is a beta plated sheet structure, or it gives the helix structure, that is sheet structure and helix structure for the polypeptide. This structure is stable by hydrogen bonding between amino group and carboxylic group. Okay, this bonding is stable by amino group and carboxylic group. Particularly, it is in helix case, it is 1,4 hydrogen bonding, and in case of a sheet structure, it is from the opposite stands, which may be parallel or anti-parallel. Let's consider in this case a helix structure and a sheet structure. Now here you can see helix structure. Here we have shown this is the carbonyl oxygen and this is the hydrogen from the, here I will put oxygen and here is the hydrogen. This hydrogen is of an amino group. Okay, now these amino group hydrogen and oxygen are showing a considerable double bond. It gives the hydrogen bonding. Okay, now here we are showing a stable structure of an alpha helix with an hydrogen bonding. This hydrogen bonding is from first amino acid with the fourth amino acid. Okay, so that gives the more stable helix structure. This helical structure stability, most of the time it is considered, or it is due to the presence of an this extended hydrogen bonding, which resulted into the more stable structure. Now let's consider for sheet structure. Here you can see a sheet structure, one polypeptide in a zigzag manner, another polypeptide in a zigzag manner, and opposite stand there is a hydrogen bonding that can be extended in a same direction or that can be on the opposite direction. Here we are having the hydrogen bonding between oxygen and the hydrogen of the amino group. Here there are two polypeptide chains combined together in a sheet like structure. There is a beta plated sheet structure shown here, one polypeptide second and polypeptide first. So this is the alpha helical structure and beta plated sheet structure, which both are stabilized by the hydrogen bonding, and this hydrogen bonding is present from the amino group and the carbonyl group. Amide bond is giving the more stable conformation for helix structure as well as a beta plated sheet structure. So what we will do, we quickly revise what we have seen in the what we are considering. First, we have seen how peptide bond is formed. It is a condensation of two amino acids with the removal of an water molecule, amino group from one amino acid, carboxylic group from another amino acid, which combine together to give the formation of amide bond. That amide bond is called as a peptide linkage or peptide bond. Depending upon the number of an peptide bond, what we are seeing, oligopeptide and polypeptide. Oligopeptide is made up of an less than 10 or 10 amino acid, and polypeptide is made up of an more than 10 amino acid. In next, what we have seen the features of an peptide bond. The Linus Pauling and Robert Corey X-ray study, it suggests that how we are getting the peptide bond features. The peptide bond formation we have seen, then we have seen its feature. Features are drawn from the X-ray study of an Linus Pauling and Robert Corey. The first nitrogen lone pair is delocalized on the carbonyl oxygen of the amide bond. Secondly, due to this delocalization, there is a considerable planar structure. There is a considerable double bond character between the carbonyl of amide and nitrogen. We are having further the study for features. The restricted rotation, it allows the formation of a more stable molecule in a three-dimensional structure with the opposite orientation of an R group, which gives a helix and a sheet structure. These structures are stabilized by a hydrogen bonding, and in last we have seen how hydrogen bonding is present in the helix structure and sheet structure. So here is the end of this lecture with the features of an peptide bond. Hope you will understand and learn these peptide bonds, study and feature by heart. Thank you very much.